We want to solve the given quadratic equation by completing the square. Completing the square is one of many methods for solving a quadratic equation. Now this video does assume you've already watched the mini lesson on completing the square, which outlines the following 5 steps for completing the square. If you haven't, you may want to watch that video, or at least pause the video and copy these steps down. So going back to our problem, to complete the square, the first step is going to be to move this constant term to the right side of the equation. So we're going to add 32 to both sides of the equation. And we're also going to set this up so we can make the left side a perfect square trinomial. So we're going to have x squared minus 4x. Notice how this is 0, but we are going to add a constant here to make this a perfect square trinomial equals, on the right side we have 32. And then if we add a constant here on the left to maintain equality, we'll also have to add a constant on the right. And now one of the most important things to remember here is to make this a perfect square trinomial, we need to add a constant here that's equal to b divided by 2 squared, where b is the coefficient of the middle term. Notice here b is equal to negative 4, so b divided by 2 squared would be negative 4 divided by 2, that's negative 2 squared, which is equal to positive 4. So we need to add 4 here on the left, but to maintain equality, we also need to add 4 on the right. And now we're going to factor the left and combine the terms on the right. This is going to be a perfect square trinomial. We'll start by factoring this into 2 binomial factors. Notice on the right we have 36. So we have the factors of x squared, x and x. The factors of positive 4 that add to negative 4 would be negative 2 and negative 2. So we have minus 2 here and minus 2 here. And now we can write this as a perfect square, where we'd have the quantity x minus 2 squared equals 36. And now we're going to use square roots to solve for x. We can undo this squaring here by taking the square root of both sides of the equation. Remember, when we do this, we would have a plus or minus sign here so that we can obtain all solutions to this equation. The left would simplify to one factor of x minus 2. And on the right, the square root of 36 is equal to 6, so we have plus or minus 6. So to solve for x, the last step is to add 2 to both sides of the equation. So we have x equals, this would be 2 plus or minus 6. Now we should list the two solutions by performing this addition and subtraction. One solution is x equals 2 plus 6, which would be 8. Or x could equal 2 minus 6, which is equal to negative 4. Notice how we have two real rational solutions. Which means the original quadratic equation could have been solved by factoring. Okay, we'll look at some more examples of completing the square in the next few videos.